Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Today we will learn about inductors. What is an inductor? Inductor is nothing else but a piece of copper wire wound as a coil. It is another basic component commonly used in electronic circuits. Whenever current flows through a conductor, magnetic field develops around it. The strength of the magnetic field depends upon the value of current passing through the conductor. The direction of the magnetic field is found using the right-hand grip rule. When current flows through a coil, each wire produces a magnetic field. But now they will merge together and form a large and more powerful magnetic field. Hence, the current flowing through a conductor wrapped as a coil produces much stronger magnetic field. So, what is an inductor? An inductor, also called as a coil, choke or reactor, is a passive two-terminal electrical component that stores energy in the form of magnetic field when electric current flows through it. Let us try to understand how does an inductor works with the help of a simple circuit. What you see here is a battery, a light bulb with an inductor connected in parallel, and a switch. When we power on this circuit, first the bulb burns brightly, then gets dimmer, and will turn off after a little time. Note that here the lamp is off instead of supply is connected. When you power off this circuit, first the bulb burns very brightly and then quickly goes out. The reason for this strange behavior is the inductor. Let me explain why this circuit behaves like this. When we power on this circuit, the electrons will start to flow through the lamp by powering it on brightly. A very small current will flow through the inductor because it have higher resistance than the filament of the lamp. Magnetic field will begin to form in the inductor. So, inductor's resistance will reduce and allows some current to flow through it. The lamp gets dimmer because of the reduced current flow through the filament. As the magnetic field keeps on building in inductor, its resistance will keeps on decreasing and allows more current to flow through it, and the lamp burns very dim. Once the magnetic field in inductor increased up to its maximum size, eventually the inductor provides nearly no resistance. So the entire current will prefer to take this path and the lamp will turn off. When we cut off the power supply, the magnetic field in the inductor will be converted into electrical energy, and this pushes the electrons around in a loop through the lamp, and the lamp burns brightly. As the magnetic field is collapsing, the lamp gets dimmer. The inductor will continue pushing the electrons through the lamp until the lamp filament resistance dissipates the energy completely and the lamp turns off. In reality, it's going to happen very fast when we power on and off this circuit. We have just slowed down the animations to make it easier to see and understand. Please note that we are using flow of electrons, which is from negative to positive. But you might be used to see conventional flow, which is from positive to negative. The key properties of an inductor is that it opposes any change in the current, and whenever the current changes, the inductor tries to stop it either by acquiring charge or losing the charge in order to keep it same as it was. So, when we power on this circuit, there will be a change in flow of current. The inductor tries to oppose this change, so it creates an opposing force known as back EMF. Some current is managed to flow through inductor, so inductor generates magnetic field which will gradually increase. Once the magnetic field reaches to its maximum, the current stabilizes. Then the inductor doesn't resist the flow of current and acts like a normal piece of wire. This creates a very easy path for the flow of current, much easier than flowing through the lamp. So the entire current will flow through the inductor and the lamp will turn off. When we power off this circuit, there will be a change or reduction in current. So the inductor tries to stop this change by losing the charge. So the magnetic field in the inductor converts back into electrical energy and tries to stabilize the current flow. This electrical energy flows through the lamp by powering it on until the resistance of the lamp dissipates the entire storage energy and the lamp turns off. When the current first starts to flow through the inductor, the magnetic field starts to expand and becomes stable at a point. So we get some energy stored in the magnetic field. When current stops flowing, the magnetic field starts to fall. At this point, the magnetic energy turned back into electrical energy and consumed by the circuit. So they are temporary storage area for energy. The current in an inductor cannot instantly change. It always lags by certain amount of time. In previous video, we discussed about how capacitors work. The main difference between a capacitor and an inductor is that a capacitor opposes a change in voltage, while an inductor opposes a change in current. Furthermore, capacitor stores energy in the form of an electric field, and an inductor stores energy in the form of magnetic field. Now let's discuss this with an example. When we connect 10 volt voltage source to a load resistor, according to Ohm's law, 1 ampere current will flow through it. If we apply 10 volts 50% duty cycle square wave pulse, then of the time 1 ampere current will flow through it. Now if we connect an inductor in series with the circuit, there is a little bit of lag in rising and falling edges of the current with respect to voltage. This is because inductor takes certain amount of time to store and release the energy. In resistors, current will follow voltage irrespective of input frequency, while in inductors, current will lag voltage by a certain time. This lag in current will be more if we raise the frequency of input signal. In an AC circuit, an inductor constantly stores and delivers energy on each and every cycle. In DC circuits, there is no change. They basically act as a piece of wire with a resistance of few milliohms. In other words, inductors resist or oppose change of current, but will easily pass a steady DC current. Inductors in circuit boards will look like this. The property of an inductor to get the voltage induced by the change of current flow is defined as inductance. Inductance is the ratio of voltage to the rate of change of current. The unit of inductance is Henry, named after American scientist Mr. Joseph Henry, who discovered the property of inductance in electrical circuit. Because Henry is large unit of inductance, hence much smaller subunits, millihenry, microhenry and nanohenry are generally employed. There are several physical factors affect the inductance of an inductor. First one, number of turns in the coil. The greater the number of turns of wire in the coil results the greater inductance. More turns of wire means that the coil can generate greater amount of magnetic field for a given amount of coil current. The inductance is proportional to the square of the number of turns in the coil. Hence, if number of turns in the coil is doubled, then its inductance increased by 4 times. Next one, cross-sectional area of the coil. The cross-sectional area of the coil is directly proportional to the inductance of the coil. It requires more wire to construct a coil of large cross-sectional area. Hence, it can generate greater amount of magnetic field. So, less opposition to the formation of the magnetic field flux. Recall the formula of area of circle pi r square. Hence, doubling the radius of a coil increases the inductance by a factor of 4. Third one, length of the coil. The length of the inductor's coil is inversely proportional to the inductance of the coil. The longer the coil's length, the lesser the inductance. The shorter the coil's length, the greater the inductance. The closer spacing increases the flux linkage, so increasing the inductance of the coil. If you double the length of a coil, its inductance becomes off. Fourth one, permeability of the core material. The greater the magnetic permeability of the core on which the coil is wrapped around, the greater is its inductance. The less permeability of the core material, the less the inductance. For example, soft iron core has magnetic permeability of 600 as compared to the air. So, it can generate greater magnetic field flux. There are many types of inductors according to the core material used and how they are constructed. For example, air core inductor, iron core inductor, ferrite core inductor and etc. An approximate inductance of any coil of wire can be found with the formula L equals to N square mu A divided by I, where L equal to inductance in Henry's, N equal to number of turns in the coil, mu equal to absolute permeability of core material, A equal to cross-sectional area of the coil, I equal to length of coil in meters. There are many applications of inductors. Now we will discuss some of them. The wide range of application of inductors in induction motors. Induction motors convert the electrical energy into mechanical energy. The shaft in the motors will rotate because of the magnetic field produced by the alternating current. Another popular application of inductors is in transformers. A combination of multiple inductors with a shared magnetic field, we can design a transformer. Transformers are found in many power supplies to increase or decrease voltages to the desired level as step-up and step-down transformers respectively. Inductors are also used as chokes. We know that inductors will create an opposite current flow when alternating current flows through it. This means inductor will choke AC current and allows DC current to pass. This property of inductors is used in power supply circuits where AC supply is converted into DC supply. Inductors are also used in relays, sensors and tuned circuits and etc. That's all about inductors. If you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. In next video, we will discuss about PN junction diode. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please click like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe and turn on notifications for more such videos. Have a nice day.